couldn't have a better evening, and just a great rivalry and a game that means so much to both these teams.
Temperature 3 degrees at the opening faceoff. The Oilers 0-3-1. Something has to give, but here it comes. McDavid in and Markstrom in the net. Able to hold that out.
Plays in the neutral zone. Looks like you're going on offense. Bang. Fogle with the good active stick. Now you're scrambling to come back, but an excellent effort of Tanev.
Blake Coleman played in a couple of outdoor games as a collegiate player. There's a chance for Dreisaitl backhand and a rebound chance. Stopped by Markstrom, and Mangiapane will clear.
Well, Ryan Huska will be telling his D that that's twice now. Turnovers in the neutral zone against that top line created two good scoring chances, and that's just easy offense you can't afford to give that McDavid Dreisaitl line. Good adjustment by Tanev the first time coming back and maybe saving the day.
And hasn't that been a return game for Calgary so far this season? Nearly a steal here in front of Markstrom with a big save. Markstrom sharp in the early point as he has been during his losing streak. There's a back in side of the net, and it'll be Kulak moving the puck. Rebound scores! Kulak moved in, and an Edmonton area kid has the opening goal of the Tim Hortons Heritage Classic.
You know, following up a couple of good shifts by the top line, just getting the puck to the net with a good traffic in front, inside position. You have both Kane and Hyman, but as you mentioned, coming back from the point, he kind of gets lost. Kulak rotated around, gets in on the back end.
And here's Dylan Dubé as Dreisaitl returns. And Leon Dreisaitl's got it with Hyman driving in. McDavid in front, scores! Zach Hyman after the Oilers kill the 5-on-3.
Evander Kane, after taking his penalty, he came out, got a good chance. Now it's Dreisaitl. And at the end of a long shift, you got some tired bodies out there for the Calgary Flames. And what Leon Dreisaitl does best is distribute the puck. Just waits and allows Hyman to get by and get the puck past the skate of Uyghur. And you can see Markstrom thinking he's got to reach out as far as he can.
And off Huberdeau and out, and they'll have to reorganize at center with time counting down on the first penalty. Nugent Hopkins getting set to return. Here comes a chance, scores! Mackenzie Uyghur tipped in front, and I think Kadri has his first of the season with 1 second remaining in the Nugent Hopkins penalty.
Close call, just making sure you're onside, then the pass across the seam, and this is a shot pass. You know, one of those with the traffic in front said how many times they weren't able to get the shot through. It got blocked. This time, Kadri's got his body in position, and he gets that one in midair as Skinner tries to get it. Look at the head up by Uyghur. He's looking at Kadri the whole time, and there's the deflection. And as you said, right at the last second. So
4.5 to go from period. Darnell Nurse back out there. Mangiapane to the attack. He got it to Backlund, a weak shot wide. Up the boards, and Dreisaitl dishing it off. Away goes Connor Brown, who had his best game on Thursday night. Had a chance at each period as he tries to come back off an ACL injury. And here's Dreisaitl centering it. Nobody there. Back to Dreisaitl again. Now McDavid turns in the zone. Across the goal mouth to Dreisaitl. Bouchard scores! An answer from the Oilers, and it's 3-1.
Leon Dreisaitl, a little give and go here with Connor McDavid. They keep it down low, and then look at sliding to his left with bodies in front. Zach Hyman's off to one side. Look at all the red sweaters, white and red sweaters in front of Markstrom. I don't think he really even sees this. And it goes right over the shoulder as Markstrom's trying to look.
Kadri got Calgary on the board. Bouchard restores a two-goal lead. Oilers looking for more in front. Markstrom there to make that stop.
Save one as, again, a turnover just inside the zone. A two-on-one down low, and Markstrom slides across. Just a little hesitation as Nugent Hopkins couldn't quite get control of it earlier.
97 on it. Lindholm trying to stay with him. Rick wide, Dreisaitl off the side of the net. And another great seam pass by McDavid. And he'll go to the net in front. Markstrom got a piece of that. Now the puck squirts loose and
3-1. These couple of early saves, there's just trying to slow down McDavid, but that pass through the seam, quick little one-timer, just the same wigs, and they had the same old style Oilers jerseys that they wore during that era as well.
And how the heck did you stand on the bench without a hat?
Honestly, the bench was so warm. Look at the guys right now too, it's the same. The heaters on the bench were quite incredible, worked well, so we didn't have to venture out too far.
So we start the second period here with the Oilers up by two. A shot turned aside by Skinner, a rebound, and they do stay out. Vogel starts back, and McDavid in flight with Drysdale. Back to McDavid, across, bubble shot. What a rush chance by Markstrom. 53-way passing play there.
And he's getting the opportunity to move up the lineup because of it.
Darnay getting set to return. Uyghur able to work his way through, and Skinner out scores on the rebound. As the penalty was about to expire, Calgary gets one back.
Spying on Connor McDavid, playing the defensive role, but this is just taking matters into your own end. Look at the pedestrian D there for the Edmonton Oilers as Ekholm gets standing still, a swipe of the stick, and Uyghur just jumps right through. Now you bring a body to you on the back check, and you forget about the guy who just came on from the bench, is Greer.
There's Coleman handing it off. Backlund centers, and Skinner across to make that stop.
Skinner, all of a sudden, there's been more traffic around his net. Puck's in there, and he does a nice job of sliding across as it goes cross crease, and Mangiapane's just in too tight there. He's unable to get it up and over.
Yes, Kyle, Edmonton always comes through when they host a big event, and this has been no exception, and it could be quite a third period, a one-goal game. Legends come in very different packages, don't they?
Yeah, you saw that one picture with the towels, too. Dwayne Mandrusiak is such a big part here.
There's a goal on a deflection. A key tip in front, I think. Off the DRA shot.
When the battle is won down low, Hyman's fighting off his man. It gets cycled up, and this is such a smart play by Desharnais. Not a hard shot, but you see the one-hopper as Kane tries at first, it looks like, to jump out of the way, but then it looks like he knocks it. That might even be Desharnais, but man, what a one-hopper. As look at the reaction of Markstrom. He can't believe how high when that hit the ice.
Kane had the Gordie Howe hat trick in Minnesota. There's a chance the other way, and the shot goes wide. Hunt swats at it, it's picked up by Dubé. He'll feed it back to Gilbert. In some trouble there on his heels. And away goes Dreisaitl. Penalty pending. Down low it goes for Fogel. McDavid calls for it and gets it. Dreisaitl on the seam pass. And that shot doesn't get to the net. Handed off with the extra attacker out now for Edmonton. Dreisaitl across, marks from the stop. And the whistle sounds, and the Oilers, with a two-goal lead, returns to the play bench as it's shot in past Skinner. Looked like he wanted to play that, but it might be icing. Coronado, that stayed in. I thought it came
up close. Yeah, it was close. Right in front of
us. It's a centering pass and a Dubé between the legs chance. Kept alive at the line, and now out empty net, Evander Kane, and that one will go to 91, and it's 5-2 Edmonton.
The emotions of the outdoor, the spectacle of 60,000, and here with the play right at the line, the play was made by Derek Ryan. It's just a good job of winning that battle. A guy who's trying to get his first one of the year will be feeling pretty happy about his performance here outdoors.
An assist for Derek Ryan. That's the first point for a bottom six forward for the Oilers this season. As the clock drains on the Calgary Flames, who will fall to 2-6-1. And the four-game winless streak for the Oilers has ended here at Commonwealth Stadium.